It is an amazing day for Yu-Gi-Oh! As we get to actually start off with round two of the YCS Summer Cup with Mech Knight versus Dino. Now, Mech Knight is going to start off with Alistair the Invoker, normal summoning it to add an invocation from the deck to the hand, and then immediately use Alistair for a link summon into Solomon Great All Mirage. Activating Pinpoint Landing in the same column as All Mirage, they'll be able to special summon Mech Knight Purple Nightfall to their side of the field and gain the effect of Pinpoint Landing to draw an additional card. For the players that wanted to know how Pinpoint Landing operates in a Mech Knight deck, this is a prime example. As now Mech Knight Purple Nightfall will activate, banishing itself to search and summon an Indigo Eclipse in the same column, using both the Amirage and the Indigo for a link summon into Mech Knight Morning Star. Now for cost, they are going to discard the World Legacy Memory to add a World Legacy Secret. You typically want to discard another Mech Knight monster here, potentially get another Light monster, so you can summon your invoked Mechaba to your side of the field for free, as well as being able to have your World Legacy Secret to have that multiple negation thing going on. But it looks like Mech Knight's going to set up really well with the at least a dual negation, and their Mech Knight monsters cannot be destroyed by battle with the monsters that they're negating due to Morning Star and the World Legacy Secrets. This is actually a really solid combo. We can show you the versatility of Mech Knights going first. Dinos are going to respond with Fossil Dig during their turn. They're going to add a level 6 or lower dinosaur monster. That's going to be the soul leading they're going to normal summon. It's going to be responded by the World Legacy Secret, targeting the Mech Knight Indigo Eclipse to be able to special summon to the side of the field. Now, Dino actually has the counter. Whoa! They're going to use Cold by the Grave to banish the Mech Knight Indigo Eclipse. Not only can Indigo Eclipse not be used during the next following turn, they won't be able to resolve the effect of World Legacy Secret to bring up the Indigo Eclipse to stop the Soul Leading. This is really good for Dinos, as long as they don't summon a monster in the Mech Knight Morning Star's column, they can pretty much activate any monster effect as long as Mech Knight doesn't have any additional hand traps. So a Terraforming is going to find a Dragonic Diagram, as Soul Leading did find a baby Ceratosaurus. And now Dragonic Diagram is going to destroy the baby Ceratosaurus in hand to be able to add a True King monster from the deck to the hand. The monster of choice is probably, or is going to be, the True King Lethosagum, but now baby Ceratosaurus's effect must activate to summon another baby from the deck to the side of the field. Soul Leading is going to destroy said baby Ceratosaurus to summon the previous one from the graveyard to the side of the field. And now it's going to trigger the new baby Ceratosaurus sent to the graveyard to be able to special summon another dinosaur monster. It's crazy how the dinosaur of baby Ceratosaurus, or the effect of baby Ceratosaurus, is not a hard once per turn. You can keep looping those to summon dinosaur monsters to your side of the field. This time it's going to be a Petit Pteranodon. Now this is no good for the Mech Knight strategy, as now Lethosagum is going to be able to fulfill its requirement to be able to destroy two Earth monsters, meaning that they can now look through Mech Knight's extra deck and banish three cards with different names. So the monster of choice is going to be that Mech Knight Crusader Avramax. That's going to be pretty problematic for Dinos. It is a huge monster that's really hard to get over. They're going to banish the second Morning Star and the invoked Paragatrio. Really interesting choice, but the Paragatrino we can assume is so they can't invocation of Miscellaneous Saracen Graveyard. Now, of course, Petit Pteranodon and the baby Ceratosaurus effect will trigger. They were destroyed on the field and sent to the graveyard. So they'll be able to special summon Miscellaneous Saracen and Giant Rex to the side of the field. This is crazy how Dinos is just popping off with some insane plays. They're going to have two level 4 or three level 4 monsters. They can use those two level 4 monsters for the summon of a Evilsaur Dulka so they can't be hand trapped, and then push for a huge amount of damage. They can do so many things with their current board. Or could they? As it looks like Mech Knights are going to have the sauce themselves. Nibiru the Primal Bean is going to tribute all monsters on the side of the field. Dinos are in an interesting spot, and this is probably the best time to Nibiru, as if they didn't, Nibiru, the Soul Leading, or the Giant Rex, or Miscellaneous Saracen could have been used for an exceed summon into Evilsaur Dulka. Really smart play by Mech Knight, noticing when to Nibiru and holding it at the perfect time. And now it looks like it's up to Dinos to see if they have a response to said Nibiru. We know that they have the Miscellaneous Saracen in graveyard, but they've already used their Soul Leading. They're going to activate a Lost World on top of their Dragonic Diagram. And now they're going to use the effect of Soul Leading banishing, or a Miscellaneous Saracen banishing the Soul Leading, the Petit Pteranodon, and the baby Ceratosaurus. They'll now be able to special summon a level 4 dinosaur monster. Players that watch the Kali effect should know the monster that is coming. It is going to be a Tyranno Infinity. This card is just heavily underrated inside of Dino decks. This is a free 4,000 attack behemoth, but it looks like Dino isn't done, as now they're going to activate Double Evolution Pill. Double Evolution Pill will banish Lethosagum as it being the only non-dinosaur monster, and the giant Rex to be able to special summon the Rex back to the side of the field, and also being able to special summon Ultimate Conductor Tyranno. So this is looking really good, as Lost World can now trigger its effect to special summon a token. And upon that token being attempted to be destroyed, Lost World can protect the token to destroy a baby Sarasaurus, which will allow them to special summon a dinosaur monster. And if it's 2,000 attack or higher, it looks like dinos will be taking game one. So this is really interesting to see how dinos are able to come back from Nibiru, not necessarily being the reason why dinos cease to exist. Giant Rex attacking into the token, Lost World will protect, and it will destroy a baby Sarasaurus, as we mentioned, but it looks like dinos don't have another 2,000 attack level 4 or lower monster. They will be able to get some really good value, as Miscellaneousaurus is a card not to be messed with. Ultimate Conductor Tyranno attacking into the token and the Nibiru. The total damage is 7,800, only 200 more damage needed for Dino to secure game one. Both the Rex and the Miscellaneousaurus will be used for an XE summon into Evolusaur Latias. Kind of smart that they don't go into Dalga, as that one's going to be a little bit easier to play around with the invoke strategy, where Latias would force that Mech Knight Indigo Eclipse at very worst just to go into the battle with the Latias, which could be flipped face down with the Ultimate Conductor Tyranno. But more importantly, it does shut off that spell trap interaction or even a summon interaction that Mech Knights may have. So it looks like this is going to be the end of Dino's turn. They make a really satisfying board, a card face down, Ultimate Conductor Tyranno, Tyranno Infinity, and Latias after being Nibiru'd. Dinos are too strong. They're going to pass it back to Mech Knights as they're going to resolve the effect of their Mech Knight Purple Nightfall. That card will be placed back to the side of the field, not special summon. And it looks like Mech Knights have the sauce and mind control. Now, this card was important to them in the last round and is serving its well-due, being able to take control of Ultimate Conductor Tyranno. Dinos have no response. They can attempt to flip the Mech Knight Indigo or Mech Knight Purple Nightfall at the cost of losing a monster, but it's just going to banish itself to search. So Dinos didn't see a real need to waste an Ultimate Conductor Tyranno. It's a monster that can't attack, probably going to be linked off. And it still puts Dinos still in ahead. Now, of course, Invocation is going to be activated. That's going to banish a Nibiru and a baby Sarasaurus. It's going to allow them to special summon an Invoked Mecha. But really interesting that Evolusaur Latias wasn't used on the Invoked Mecha. As now Invocation will add that Alistair back to the hand. It can be normal summoned to the side of the field using its effect to search that Invocation again. So yeah, again, really interesting that Dinos did not use Evolusaur Latias' effect to negate that invocation. I thought that would be a critical choke point, but it still looks like it's Mech Knight's turn to lose, as they're gonna have to get rid of the Ultimate Conductor Tyranno with 4,000 attack, and it kind of explains why they let the Tyranno Infinity go. They had the Infinite Impermanence to stop the Tyranno Infinity. They have to deal with a huge Nibiru too, so it looks like Dino is just gonna bank on their strong monsters on their side of the field to carry them into the next game. But while I have you guys this time, I want to talk to you guys about the YCS Summer Cup 2020. This is an amazing 16-deck bracket decided by you guys, the players. As always, I want to thank my judges, my players, my editors, and everyone in between. Of course, you guys, the watcher, are just as equally as important. For the players that want to see deck profiles, I always tend to post them on Patreon. I'm back from Missouri, so I can start posting deck profiles again. But we will also be posting some of these deck profiles on YouTube, so go ahead and hit that subscribe button, as well as the notification bell, so you can stay tuned for more awesome content. Now it looks like Mech Knight is going to make Alistair the Invoker of Madness, and now follow up with the second copy of Invocation. I feel like that Evolusaur Latias could be used to take a bet, They can say, hey, do you have that additional monster? I'm going to use Logia to negate that invocation this time around. But it still is almost like, why didn't you stop the invoked Mechaba right here? Maybe actually just saving that Evilsaur Logia for another type of summon of a monster. It's really hard to gauge what Dino wants to do. So this actually wasn't the deciding factor of the Evilsaur Logia, just providing some insight on what Dino's could have done. Stopping, not stopping it is also still a really good situation. Maybe they just want to protect that Tyranno Infinity and their token on their side of the field, because that's easily going to be the win condition for Dinos right now. That token is, it's huge. The Tyranno Infinity is huge, and Mech Knight only has 200 life points left. So this isn't a terrible strategy, rather a solid strategy that could ride them to victory. So now it looks like Evilsaur Logia is going to be forced to negate the second invocation. That's going to allow them to be able to use the effect of Hooker Nightfall to search exactly what they need. It's actually starting to make sense. They were probably looking to stop the Red Moon, which makes perfect sense. If you don't care about the invoked Mechaba, you really don't care about what they're going to make. You care about that, that Red Moon. If you can negate the summon of the Red Moon, you're pretty good. But now they're prompted to stop the second invocation. It's almost inevitable. And they're going to lose one of their monsters to the Red Moon. So now Mech Knight's taking their time. It's going to take some time to be able to break a board with monsters that sit at 5,000 and 10,000 attack range. Especially if you can't just summon monsters to attack over it. I think that the Red Moon is going to be special summoned to where the Nibiru is under. Provided that they have a, you know, actually they do have column placements. They have the Alistair. And now they're just going to have to worry about the Tyranno Infinity if they want to bring this game back into their favor. Red Moon is going to banish the Mech Knight Morning Star. That's going to get rid of the token. And people typically do ask me, where do I get these tokens? Ladies, I've had them for who knows how long. I can't tell you exactly where I've had these tokens because they're very, very old Pokemon Tops cards. But we'll probably be looking to making our own tokens. We definitely have our own certs and whatnot and own merchandise for you guys to represent the Cali Effect King of Games. So now Alistair and Mech Knight Blue Sky will be used into a Nightmare Unicorn. That's pretty good for Mech Knights as they're now going to discard a card from their hand to be able to get rid of that Tyranno Infinity. A second pinpoint landing will do to get that Tyranno Infinity back into the deck, maybe hoping that the opponent doesn't have a way to get to it. Plot twist, they do. There is a Miscellaneous Saracen Graveyard, so there is plenty of work for Mech Knights, plenty of ground for them to cover. Dinos still feel like they have this in the game, or in the bag. Attacking over the Evilsaur Logia, and then direct. Unfortunately for them, that's not enough damage to finish Dinosaur off, 4,600, which is going to bring Dinos down to a 3,400 life point range. They're going to set a card face down, and that's going to be the end for Mech Knights. Now, Dinos are at a huge opportunity right now by banishing the Miscellaneous Saris. Provided that Mech Knights doesn't have a monster negation, if they can play around that, they can get that Tyranno Infinity back to their side of the field, provided that they get enough dinosaur monsters in the graveyard and just outright win this game. But it looks like during the standby phase, they are going to call by the grave the Miscellaneous Saris. There was enough dinosaur monsters to be able to summon the second Tyranno Infinity. And it looks like Mech Knights just completely swept this game right into their favor. That was completely crazy, ladies and gentlemen. Dinos being 200 life points away from winning this game. But it looks like Mech Knights were able to turn the tide. I wouldn't expect anything less from the top two finalists of the YCS Lockdown Tournament. Will Dinos be able to keep their title going for the Summer Cup? Or will Mech Knights play spoiler and finally get their revenge? I want you guys to post down below in the comment section, which strategy do you think will win? As Dinos is starting off with a pretty solid game too. They're gonna go Anim Adorned Arcosaur, destroying the Baby Sarasaurus to add a double evolution pill. Now the Baby Sarasaurus will spell summon the Soul Eating, and Soul Eating will use its effect to destroy the Anim Adorned? That's going to spend some of the baby Sarasaurus back to the side of the field. Obviously, no dinos were destroyed or no babies were destroyed, so no special summon. But now Miscellaneous Saris will banish itself to be able to special summon a Drac Aelil to the side of the field. Now, some players may not like the Cinco combo, period, but It really helps if you want to be a competitive Dino player, as Tristan Hauk will be able to special summon a Mecha Phantom Beast O-Lion from your deck to your side of the field. There's so many variants to this synchro combo, I actually do find it rather entertaining. You guys are about to experience a variant of the synchro combo that you have never seen before. Now, Link Cross will special summon two tokens to the side of the field. Both the tokens and the O-Lion will be used for the synchro summoner, one token and an O-Lion, into Martial Metal Marcher. Marcher's effect will special summon back to the side of the field, but O-Lion will also trigger to be able to special summon a token. Dracaelio is going to be the monster of choice to be special summoned, and keep in mind that token on the bottom was special summoned through O-Lion and can be used for a Link. So here's where some really cool things are going to happen, as the token and the Link Cross will be used into a Link summon into Reproductus. Reproductus is going to change Martial Metal Marcher into an Earth monster, and both those monsters will be used for a Synchro summon into Notoria Beast. Now the Dracaelio and the token will be used for a Synchro summon into Formula Synchron. That's going to allow Dinos to draw an additional card from their deck to their hand. But even more importantly, Dino has another way to get into Notoria Beast. That is huge against Mech Knights. While they could special summon a monster stronger than it, Dinos typically have a disruption through the double evolution build into an Ultimate Conductor Tyranno, and it looks like they're going to be adding more sauce with Nemesis Flag. Nemesis Flag will shuffle in the Miscellaneous Cerasaurus to be able to special summon itself, and then it will activate its effect to add a Nemesis monster from the deck to the hand. That's going to add a Niscaros, which is crazy because now Nemesis Archer and Formula Synchron are both on the side of the field. I don't know what exactly you can do with that, but I know you guys, as intelligent players, know you can Synchro Summon with both the Formula Synchron and the Nemesis Flag. Now, both of those monsters will be used into the monster that everybody knows and loves. It's going to be a Herald of Arclight made with the Formula Synchron and Nemesis Flag. There's a little bit of an interesting fact that I want you guys to know about this combination of cards. Notoria Beast does send from the deck to the graveyard as cost, and Herald of Arclight says any cards sent from the main deck are banished instead. Now, the problem with this is you won't be able to use the effect of Notoria Beast as long as Herald of Arclight is on the field, because Notoria Beast must send cards from the deck to the graveyard in order to activate its effect. But the cool thing about this is that you can just use Herald of Arclight's effect first, and then you can use the effect of Notoria Beast. So while it may not come up in certain situations, your opponent just might activate two spell cards, it can come up in a situation where your opponent maybe wants to go into attack or has to activate monster effects, but more importantly, you have a Notoria Beast on their side of the field. How can you deal with that? Alistair the Invoker is going to be normal summoned, and Dinos are just going to allow it to add the invocation from the deck to hand. This would actually have been a perfect time to use that Herald of Arclight. And now Mech Knight is a little skeptical, setting a card face down. They're going to special summon that Mech Knight Blue Sky, try to use that effect, and that's where that Herald of Arclight is going to activate. Mech Knight, knowing that this is not a great scene right now, they're going to special summon Mech Knight Green Horizon to their side of the field, use both the Green Horizon and the Alistair the Invoker for an Exceed summon into Mech Knight Morning Star. They now can use the effect of Morning Star to get a free search, so really cheeky of Mech Knight to actually be able to get that. They'll discard the World Legacy Whispers, but it's met with an Ash Blossom and Joyous Spring. This is no bueno for Mech Knight, as the Ash Blossom is going to hit a critical juncture, preventing them from getting the World Legacy Secret. That's their play card. And now the invocation is going to be met with the Notoria Beast, sending a Macel. Dinos showing that they have the Escados to just follow up for game, and we are going into game three. Never would have thought that these two strategies would be duking it at so hard, but it just shows how powerful both of these strategies are and why they deserve to be in the YCS Lockdown Finals. Now, round two in the Summer Cup, it looks like Girsu is going to be halted by an Ash Blossom, but that's met by a Called by the Grave. Mech Knights at least have the True King of All Calamity combo right now. If they have a Mech Knight monster in their hand, they also have the full hand wipe and extra deck wipe. That's something that actually Dinos out of all decks can come back from. They're going to use their token for Link Kreebo, and they do have the Mech Knight Purple Nightfall, so they do have full combo, ladies and gentlemen. without disruptions from Dino, they can rip the entire hand and extra deck and send it completely to the graveyard. Now, the actual cool thing about Dinos is that while Mech Knight can rip the entire hand and extra deck, Dinos can still play through it. If they send a Miscellaneous Saris to the graveyard, well, guess what? They can have the strongest monster on the board by banishing four monsters in the graveyard to be able to special summon the Tyranno Infinity. Now, granted, that is given the fact that Dinos would have to send four dinosaur monsters from their hand to the graveyard to be able to gain Macelle's effect. But hear me out. There's still other combos. Soul Eating can actually search your double evolution pill. So that's also a thing to be able to special summon Ultimate Conductor Tyranno. But I'm going to move back into the Mech Knight combo. You guys have seen a plethora of cards being summoned to the side of the field. This is a standard combo that I've had in a deck profile. Of course, I'll leave links down below for you guys to see. Link Cross is going to special summon two tokens. Both tokens are not mandatory, but they'll use one of those tokens for a Link summon into Link Kribo and then special summon the Mech Knight Indigo Eclipse. Now, both the Girsu and the Indigo Eclipse. No, it looks like the Link Kribo and the Girsu, that can't be used for a Link summon. The Indigo Eclipse and the Link Kribo will be used for a Link summon. Keep in mind that Link Kribo was special summoned by tributing a token, not Link summon, into the Morningstar, discarding that Mech Knight Purple Nightfall that was added from the banish pile to the hand through World Legacy Key. This is how the Mech Knight strategy gets World Legacy Scars. And now they're going to use both the Morningstar and the Girsu for another Link summon. They're going to actually special summon Spectral Supreme. Spectral Supreme can send the World Legacy Key from the field to the graveyard to special summon another Mech Knight monster with a different name to their side of the field. They're going to special summon Green Horizon. And now almost the table is pretty much set. I'm pretty sure they're going to have enough Mech Knight monsters to resolve their World Legacy field spell using both the Link Cross and the Spectral Supreme into the Avramax. And the token can't be used for a Link summon because that was the one summoned through Link Cross. But all three of the remaining monsters can for the Link summon into Black Luster Soldier. Soldier of Chaos. Now they're going to follow up with their filled spell card and World Legacy Scars. They do have eight, that's right, eight Mech Knight monsters in the graveyard to banish with that two card combo. They can proceed to send Dino's entire hand to the graveyard. Three dinos. Okay, that's pretty good as they'll be able to summon a decent sized dino to their side of the field following up, but they do lose their entire extra deck. This is going to be all dependent on the dino draw. They can come back into this game still. I believe in them, and if there's any deck that can still play through the Mech Knight Disrupt, Dino just has to be one of them. So both players are going to shuffle each other's decks, and we're going to get into the next turn. Dinos are going to see if they have what it takes. They're going to go into their standby phase. Looks like Mech Knights is going to look through the graveyard of Dinos, and they have the Cold by the Grave. This is insanity. Mech Knights are definitely looking to go into the next round. That Cold by the Grave is going to banish the Miscellaneous Saris, but Dinos have the Fossil Dig. There is hope, ladies and gentlemen. That Fossil Dig can be huge. They can use this Fossil Dig to add a Soul Eating, normal summon a Soul Eating, send Overtax Quetless from the deck to the graveyard, and then gain the effect of Quetless to add a double evolution pill, and voila, you have an Ultimate Conductor Tyranno to your side of the field. The game can very well much be back in your favor. This is huge for the Dino strategy, ripping that Fossil Dig. They're gonna normal summon the Soul Eating and activate the monster effect. Is it going to be disrupted by Mech Knights? Do they have anything? No, it looks like it is not, but they're going to add the Miscellaneous Saris. What is going on? Oh, that's unfortunate. I'm looking at the deck list right now for Dinos, and they don't play the Overtex Quetless. This is big crybaby tears, as they can get the Miscellaneous Sarasaurus. It can't be used this turn. It was called by the grave. It can't be used on the opponent's turn because called by the grave. And Mech Knights still did have World Legacy Key. So the World Legacy Key is going to allow them to add a banished Mech Knight monster to their hand. They returned the Mech Knight Indigo Eclipse for the part of the combo and then banished it. So it's not going to return to their side of the field. But now they can add the Indigo Eclipse from their banished pile to their hand and re-special summon it. BLS Soldier of Chaos does now occupy a column, as well as the World Legacy key occupies the column. They're going to special summon Blue Sky to the side of the building, use the effect of Blue Sky to add Indigo Eclipse. And Mech Knights can continue to play this game. Now, this is really unfortunate for Dinos, but looking on the bright side, Miscellaneous Urus is still a play. They can discard it on their following turn, and they should have enough dinosaur monsters to be able to summon another Soul Eating and pop off with some plays. This isn't completely over for the Dino Enthusiast. Heck, if they draw a dinosaur monster, they can summon Animadorn to their side of the field and really go off. Now, World Legacy Succession is going to be activated. That is going to special summon a World Legacy World Armor. And now World Armor will be able to search from their decks to their hand another World Legacy card. This is not looking good. We know that BLS can attack at least twice. It can attack once and banish, or it can attack twice. They're going to add the World Legacy Secrets from their deck to their hand. And I'm not going to lie, this is looking really bleak for Dinos. Bet you they wish that they played that monster. BLS is going to attack into both the Soul Eating and the token. And it looks like that is actually enough for game. Really unfortunate that Dino doesn't have anything to respond right now. I know Dino players are crying, but Mech Knight players get to rejoice, mainly because Mech Knights get their revenge from the YCS Lockdown Tournament and knock Dinos out of the bracket. This has been really exciting watching round two, and we still have three other exciting games to show you guys. Who will win in these games, ladies and gentlemen? I want you guys to post down below in the comment section which of these guys are going to the semifinals. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next video.